Today is a very joyous day for us in the Archdiocese, and especially here at St. Mary's Cathedral, since we celebrate the feast day of our Mother Church, the Cathedral today, St. Mary of the Assumption. We can have a gathering of people on the plaza at these various Masses so that we can manifest the joy we feel on this day and publicly express our faith and show to our city, to our communities, that God is important. God is the most important thing. God has to be at the center of our lives. All of the counties in California that are on the watch list are allowed to have outdoor Masses. Depending on the county, the number varies. San Francisco is very restrictive, only allowing 12 at any sort of outdoor gathering. The idea came to my mind because we have a number of priests here at the cathedral and other priests at the chancery who are available for Mass. We have a very large plaza on the in front of the cathedral. There's plenty of room to have multiple Masses at the same time. The thought came to my mind because I envisioned many people on the plaza, even if they cannot be at the same Mass worshiping together, they can worship together in smaller groups. So this is a way that we can publicly manifest our faith and give expression to our faith in greater numbers so the world can be reminded of the importance of the centrality of God to our society. As Catholics, we have a sacramental vision of the world, and we see the church building is not just a practical matter of convenience to be able to be inside and protected from the elements. The church has a sacramental significance. It symbolizes the church that is the people of God, as St. Peter says, built up of living stones. It is of the essence of the church that we gather for worship. We do so insofar as we can in the circumstances in which we gather, as the church has done all throughout history. So we are allowed, thank God, we are allowed at least to have Mass outdoors without any interference from the government. So we do as best we can for the time being. So it's not an adequate substitute, but we do what we can under the circumstances in which we find ourselves, as the church has always done throughout her history. And so there is also this distancing from the importance of God at the center of society. History has also proven whenever that happens, whenever a society or a nation turns its back on God and denies God, it always begins to corrupt and eventually fall apart. So we need to reclaim God at the center of our society. We see this in various ways. We also see it in the ways in which the health orders in certain parts of the state, including here in San Francisco, are being unequally applied. Certain types of activity, especially religious activities, being more greatly restricted than other types of secular activities. We've seen this elsewhere as well. We've seen it, for example, in Nevada, where casinos are allowed to operate and churches still cannot have indoor services. So we see this unequal application. This is just one example of what happens when we remove God from the center of society. As Catholics, we need to ask, first of all, God for the grace to bear this patiently and with integrity. It would not be right for us to lash out in retaliation. It certainly would not be right for us to violate health orders that could worsen the spread of the coronavirus, that could endanger infecting other people. But we also need to lobby our government leaders and make our voices heard, that we simply want to be treated equally to everyone else. Worship is a First Amendment issue. It's one of the primary rights, visions of the founding of this country, that the state would not interfere in the affairs of the church, and the church also has no authority to run the state. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May he let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May he look upon you kindly and grant you his peace, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.